Today we have all been waiting to celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. There's so much significance that we are in a place here, the same time of a heart Jesus had when he was born. And the wind was blowing from all sides, and it was difficult to keep the room very warm. Though, if it is correct, he was not born in the month of December, in a warmer month, not so very cold, maybe this much, as you say. So maybe that the climate of today is quite significant with the climate that he must have felt. As for you people, you don't feel any discomfort in this climate, nor in the surroundings, nor in the Spartan living. He never felt any discomfort, nor his mother. When our attention is on our spirit, then we do not feel the discomfort of nature or of worldly things. This is the first sign when a Sahaja Yogi starts complaining about comforts, then the first sign is that he is not a Sahaja Yogi as yet. To begin with, we just get absolutely acclimatized with the climate and enjoy the style, the speed, the way it is molding you. There's no friction between the nature and the body, because the spirit, which is synchronizer, helps you to become one with this nature and enjoy the best part of it. The way you are enjoying it shows that you are great sages. And that goes to my credit, I think, that you people have accepted all the discomfort as enjoyments. Christ's coming was a great event, as I have told you, to establish our gadget. And he was born on this earth, but much before he was born in the consciousness. And that absolute consciousness itself took birth as Jesus Christ. To explain his life is only possible if you are realized souls. Otherwise you cannot explain Christ, what he was, how he worked. Still, it's very difficult to explain many things in Sahaja Yoga, as you know. You just go on seeing things. Today you saw fountains coming out of the lake, which nobody can explain. Even the engineer said they can't explain, nobody can explain it. It just happens that the water gets excited, feels the divinity, and starts pouring out its love in a bubbly manner. Can you imagine that even the water can feel it? You have seen how the light can feel it. In the same way, every element can feel it. All those elements are within us. The highest of all, as we say, is the light. Because light has an effect, and that is governed by Jesus Christ. Light has an effect. Light shows things that are correct. That's the one which makes us understand all the dimensions of worldly things. And ultimately, when this light comes from the Spirit, and is enlightened by the Spirit, then you start seeing the other dimensions also, which sometimes make you laugh, sometimes make you smile, and sometimes make you cry also. Such a beautiful new dimension you have achieved through Sahaja Yoga. But it was all built in within you and you had to achieve it. People on the other side had to work very hard. Like Jesus Christ was born in a small manger to show that divinity need not be born in royal families, can be born in a manger, can be born anywhere, makes no difference to the divinity. But that has given some funny ideas to people that they are saying we should make ourselves miserable and we should give away everything to God. God doesn't want it. He cannot have it. And you cannot give it. It's a wrong idea that you become like a pauper and give everything to God. He doesn't want that. What He wants that you have to be happy, joyous and enjoy. That's the main point. Also, if you give little bit, very little bit to God, then He gives you 100 times more. That's why you have to give a very wee bit to God. But you don't have to hang yourself by the trees to prove that you want to sacrifice. Christ has done everything for you. That's the beauty of His life, is that from the very beginning of His birth, He has shown that He has enjoyed no material well-being, as we call it. He has not enjoyed any worldly things as we know of. But that just means that He has done that for us to see that there is no need for us to hanker after worldly things. They will hanker after us. You don't have to worry about these things. What you have to worry is the spirit, the main thing. All His life, which was very short, I should say, He has been trying. He was very much interested in evaluating people, because He didn't know what sort of things these human beings are. He was a foreigner for these human beings. So He tried to evaluate, and in that evaluation He said many things which are very remarkable and one has to understand. One of the things He said, that don't throw your pearls before people who do not want to understand you. But Sahaja Yogis, it is important to understand that you should not talk about Sahaja Yoga to people who are anti-God. Now He may be your brother, maybe your sister, maybe your father, maybe anyone. There is no need to convince them about Sahaja Yoga, because they are not your relations. Many people have only this worry, how to convince my husband or how to convince my brother. There is no need at all for you to work it out. Just give them up on this point. The another thing He has told us, which is very important I think, that we must forgive. He has given the greatest weapon that we must forgive. Now, it's such a practical thing to forgive. If you just forgive, the person doesn't exist anymore and the person doesn't trouble you anymore, nor is he in your attention. Just to forgive is the simplest thing to do and the highest thing to do to get relief from worldly or mental tortures that we get. His life has been a story of spirituality going through all kinds of turmoils and tortures, all types of troubles that the spirit can go through, to show that nobody can kill that spirit. As it said in the Gita, Nainam Chiranti Shastrani, Nainam Dahati Pavaka, Nachainam Kledayantyapo Nashosayati Maruta. It cannot be killed, it's an eternal life. And he tried to prove through his life the eternity. From the beginning to the end, he showed that spirit is above matter, that nothing can dominate spirit. It's a very big thing he has done for us, is to create such a big confidence in our spirit. He has proved it beyond doubt. I hope you people will understand and will not bother me or bother yourself with small petty things here and there. It's nothing important. Ask for bigger things, eternal things, valuable things. Also, I'm very happy that you like this place and you're enjoying yourself here very much. And today we have declared so many marriages. There have been so many events in this short time. So I would like to bless you all for this Christmas Eve. And I wish you all a very happy Christmas and Happy New Year.